Welcome back. You're watching The Money Show on ET Now. Well, let's continue our conversation around mid and small cap funds. Some of you may have been disappointed with what that segment of the market has done, but some have reason to rejoice as well. One such fund is the unit holders of the Edelweiss Small Cap Fund, which from its inception has done really well. And interestingly, Edelweiss MF believes that mid and small caps will outperform going forward. So let's introduce on the show Harshad Patwardhan, the CIO for Equity with Edelweiss Asset Management. Mr. Patwardhan, thank you so much for joining us today on ET Now and on The Money Show. So to start with, it's a very interesting report, you know, that you've released. Let's talk about first the key reasons why you believe mid and small caps will finally outperform, I think, what, 2 to 3 years of a lull later?
Sure. Thanks for having me. Good evening to all your viewers. If you look at the last few years, 2018 and 2019, were the 2 years where mid-cap index significantly underperformed large-cap index to the extent of 19 and 16%. So if you look at the history of last 20 years, when mid-cap index data is available, these were the two worst years for mid-cap performance vis-a-vis large-caps. We believe that going forward, things are going to look better for mid-caps and small-caps for three main reasons. Firstly, one of the reasons why we saw 18-19 underperformance of mid-caps, you might recall that that was a period of very narrow kind of a rally. Even among large-caps, only a handful of stocks were doing well. The reason for that was the Indian economy. Even before COVID struck last year, Indian economy was decelerating for almost 4-5 years even before that. Earnings growth, even if you look at Nifty companies, was extremely lackluster. So there were only a handful of businesses that were doing relatively okay.
So, okay, I think we have just lost Mr. Patwardhan's line over there. But, I was just going through his report actually, and I think we've managed to get Mr. Patwardhan back. Continue your point, sir.
Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir. Go ahead. You were making a point on Mr. Patwardhan, you were making a point on what are the, data you've crunched to come to the conclusion that there is a possibility of the broader markets to outperform. So please do continue with that.
So, exactly. So, the rebound in the economy that we have seen, and if you look at the corporate results, it's very evident that this recovery is likely to be more broad-based. Point number two, the policymakers, both RBI, with liquidity conditions being very, very benign, and also the rates being low, is good for inclusive broad-based growth. And thirdly, government clearly wants, has a single-minded focus on inducing growth in the economy. And if you look at the some of the specific initiatives taken by the government in terms of infrastructure, in terms of PLI scheme, etc., they are very beneficial for many businesses or many sectors which are predominantly in small cap and mid cap. And lastly, if you look at the 20-year historical, the base probability, as they say, we have seen that over long periods of time, mid caps and small caps tend to outperform large caps. And that's the reason why I believe that over the medium term, mid caps, small caps will do better than large caps.
Mr. Patwardhan, let's also talk then about the fact that you have noticed about how there has been better performance by mid and small cap funds after certain periods of time. Now, 18, 19, 20, of course, to a large extent has seen underperformance. So, how do you sort of read into this? How do you analyze into these periods of underperformance followed by outperformance? If you could just share your findings with our viewers.
Sure. So, as I said, 18, 19 were underperformance years. 20 was all right. 20, there was a modest outperformance of mid-cap index over large-cap index. And, before I get into the comparison, it's very important to remember that these comparisons are at the index level. If you actually look at actively managed funds in mid-caps and small-cap category, they have generally generated much higher alpha compared to the large cap scheme. So if you did this comparison, mid cap funds versus large cap funds, mid caps have done even better than what the index comparison suggests. It's always very difficult to forecast, you know, what might happen in the future. But as I mentioned, if you look at a 20-year history, data for which is available, because mid cap index started about 20 years ago, over long periods of time, mid cap index has generated, I think, 2.7-2.8% outperformance on a CAGR basis compared to large cap. So compounded over 20 years, that's a very, very large outperformance. The other way to look at it is if you look at the rolling returns, because typically we advise investors to come into equity at least for 3 to 5 years. So if you look at rolling return analysis, 65% of the time, so roughly 2/3 of the time, mid-cap index has done better than large-cap index. If you extend that time horizon to 5-year rolling return, then 77% of the times, mid-cap index has done better than large-cap index. So I think the odds of mid-cap outperformance are very, very good, particularly after 1819, which were the worst years for relative performance.
So yeah, 1-2% outperformance theoretically may sound really low, but of course think about it. You're investing for the long term, 10 years, 15 years, so it's going to compound. So it will eventually turn out to be a large outperformance. Okay, so Mr. Patwardhan, then for all of our retail investors who have units in small cap and mid cap funds, do you think that now is a good time for them to perhaps up their SIPs as well, increase their SIPs in these funds?
SIP is always a great idea when it comes to mid-caps and small-cap mandates because of the inherent volatility involved in the underlying stocks. So I think SIPs is one good way to, in a way, work that volatility for you. So SIPs is always a good idea. However, I would like to point out that if you look at the history and in the report that you mentioned, we have one slide which basically suggests that if you believe that things are turning, the returns tend to be front-ended. So investors who have the risk appetite to invest in, and that is a very, very important thing. Not everybody may have a risk appetite to invest in these kind of funds, but investors who do have the risk appetite, they can also think in terms of lump sum investment because the returns tend to be front-ended.
All right. You know, let's talk about your own fund, the Edelweiss Small Cap Fund. I think since inception, great outperformance. You've beaten the index as well, the Small Cap Index and the BSE. So what's been your investment strategy, if you'd like to, you know, share a message as well with your unit holders who are watching?
Thank you for pointing that out. So two, three things. One, clearly in small cap and mid cap investing, bottom up stock picking is very, very important. So that goes without saying. The sizing of bets is also very, very important. But the third thing, my most important thing, if you look at last few years, the fund was launched about 2 years ago, is that it has to be a very, very actively managed mandate. Because if you look at last few years, it was full of ups and downs, right? 2019, we launched it in the run-up to the general elections and the associated volatility. Then around October, November of 2019, there were actually green shoots in the economy and it appeared that things are looking up. And then last year, we had this whole COVID disruption and the fall in the markets in March and then subsequent recovery. So, it was a very, very eventful period in the markets. And it's very important that you understand how things are changing and adapt to that. So active management of fund, I think, has contributed a lot to the performance, apart from, of course, the selection of stocks and the sizing of bets.
Great. All right. Thank you so much, Harshad, for joining us today on the show and, you know, sharing those interesting insights from your report. I suppose it'll sort of provide some comfort of sorts as well to a lot of unit holders of mid and small cap funds. Essentially, remember that patience is key, especially when you are invested in this category. And with that, we'll take a very short break on the show, but we'll return with our Spend with EMS segment. And today, we will be talking tech with Nikhil Chawla. Okay, you know what? Before we do that, we have Nestle's fourth quarter numbers that have just hit the screen. So very quickly, let's address what the company has done in Q4. Remember, they follow the calendar year system of accounting. So hence, it is Q4. You know, this is a company in the packaged foods, which is expected to do well. And I think largely, they have more or less met expectations, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, 3,400 crores was the top line expectation. And guess what? They've delivered 3,433 crores. So, not bad, really. No complaints on that front. There is an uptick of a little over 8% on their top line. The profit after tax, meantime, has as well come more or less in line with expectations, a tad bit below at 483 crore versus 536 crores. You know, I think in this previous quarter, we had seen very high food inflation. I wonder if that has got anything to do with it. EBITDA is at 777 crores. Yeah, so I think the margin is the problem. It's a bit lower than expectations at 22.6%. Our expectation was 23.6%. So I think that's where, you know, Nestle did sort of underperform a little bit. But otherwise, I think top line inline margins are, I think, something that perhaps has left the street wanting more. And for now, we'll take a very short break. Be back with our Spend with TMS segment.